Good evening. Tonight I'd like to reflect with you on the gospel for Thursday of the 19th week in ordinary time. It's taken from the 18th chapter of St. Matthew. Peter approached Jesus and asked him, "Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive him? As many as seven times?" Jesus answered, "I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, 'Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full.' Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, 'Pay back what you owe.' Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, 'Be patient with me and I will pay you back.' But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the last debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, 'You wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you?' Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives his brother from his heart." When Jesus finished these words, he left Galilee and went to the district of Judea, across the Jordan. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, today's Gospel is very fitting on this memorial of St. Pontian and St. Hippolytus. One was a pope, one was an anti-pope, and they died together, suffering a martyr's fate. Pope Pontian was pope from the year 230 to 235, and during the reign of Emperor Maximinus Thrax, he was captured, sent into exile in Sardinia, and made to work in the mines, where he suffered a cruel death. St. Hippolytus was a Roman priest. He was a well-renowned theologian. He opposed the Sabellianist heresy. He was also a rigorist, inasmuch as during a time of persecution, when many Christians wavered in their faith and handed over the holy books to the Roman officials, later St. Callistus wanted to reconcile them, and he was fairly lenient with them, kind and merciful to them. But St. Hippolytus thought he was too lax, that he was not exercising the papal ministry properly, and set himself up as an anti-pope against first Callistus and then later Pontian. But when Maximinus Thrax began his severe persecution of Christians, well, even Hippolytus was rounded up and also sent to Sardinia. We do not know exactly how it happened, but the two brothers managed to reconcile. They were brothers in Christ, in life, and in death. And sometimes even within the family of God, there are disputes. But these two martyrs teach us that we are always to witness to Christ, and we are always to be instruments of unity, reconciliation, and peace. Yesterday, I spoke about being a church that reconciles and being a church of the reconciled. In yesterday's gospel, Jesus said, if your brother has offended you and you're hurt by him, you should go and confront him. And if he doesn't listen to you when he has done wrong, go and bring two or three others. And if he still doesn't listen, well, then bring the church. And if he still doesn't listen to the church, well, treat him as you would a tax collector or a foreigner. Moreover, Jesus then gave his disciples the power of the keys to bind and loose sins. We are to be a church that reconciles and a church of the reconciled. But today's gospel then follows on that, because Peter asked Jesus, "Lord, how many times must I forgive my brother then? Seven times? This brother who has hurt me, seven times?" And Peter's thinking he's being magnanimous, great with his mercy, generous. And Jesus says, no, not seven times, 77 times, meaning an infinite number of times if he's truly sorry. He then tells the parable about a king who had someone, a debtor, brought before him, who owed him a huge amount and had no way of paying it back. And the master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, children, all his property in payment of the debt. Well, the man fell at the master's feet and begged him for mercy. Be patient with me and I will pay you back in full. He had no way of doing it. But the master was moved with compassion and let him go and forgave him the loan. We are the debtor. God is the master. We have no way of paying him back for the sin of our first parents. We have no way of paying him back for our multiple sins. We cannot forgive ourselves. But God is moved with compassion. He sees our misery, the misery of sin. And if we ask him forgiveness, if we ask him for patience, then he, moved with compassion, will forgive us. And that is why the church has instituted the sacrament. Christ himself has instituted the sacrament of penance and reconciliation. Yes, God is moved with pity when we are truly sorry, when he sees our misery, and when we are willing to change. In fact, in order to pay back the debt owed, he gave us his own son, who is true God and true man. For it was humanity, our first parents, who had sinned against God and incurred the debt. Man it was who had to pay God back, but he had no way of doing it. Only God could really make proper recompense. But in the mystery of the incarnation, humanity and divinity are joined. It was humanity who had sinned. Now in the person of Jesus Christ, the Son of God and true man, a man makes amends. He who is God, so he's also able to. And so he makes satisfaction, reparation for our sins. He pours out his blood for the forgiveness of sins. But how do we respond to God's generosity toward us, toward God's mercy? Are we not sometimes like the servant who had his debts forgiven? When we find someone else who has wronged us, who owes us, and then who owes us much, do we forgive easily? Do we forgive readily? Or do we say, pay back what you owe, and refuse, and are severe with them? Do we not hold on to grudges rather than forgive? Why do we not show the same compassion toward those who have forgiven us, who have sinned against us, who have hurt us? Sometimes it's true we are wounded. We can allow those wounds to foul and fester, or those wounds can be openings for God's grace to come in, to heal us, and to allow us to be generous in bringing healing and forgiveness to others. Jesus tells us that unless we forgive our brothers, our sisters from our hearts, our Heavenly Father will not forgive you, give us. But the Father desires that all should be saved and that none should perish. His is a heart full of mercy and compassion, eager to forgive. Saints Pontian and Hippolytus, show us how we fragile creatures can forgive one another, can be reconciled, and be united in the Lord, united forever in the Lord.